who are in the community that it is very important that you take help from the influencers who are there in the community or the local community leaders to establish a rapport with the people there. The activities which you will undertake when you are in the community is increasing the general awareness, community surveillance. So first we'll talk about the general awareness when you are in the community. So you will be taking help of the local influencers in the community, and the messages for communication will include messages on hand hygiene, respiratory hygiene, social distancing or physical distancing, then about the home care and quarantine, which Dr. Ritu has just talked about in a session before, and monitoring of the signs and symptoms. That is, if someone falls sick, how are they going to see that? What are the symptoms which you have been told about? Fever, cough, and difficulty in breathing. So these are the five important messages which you are going to deliver. But how and where you are going to deliver? So usually what is the mode of communication is that we can do miking, we can send WhatsApp messages, we can share some videos on WhatsApp, and we can have, you know, flyers and pamphlets to be distributed in the community. So in the current situation of lockdown, the IC material, it can be either displayed at appropriate places, which is like essential services shops, like the pharmacy, grocery shops, or you can use the miking, which is available with the garbage collection vans, the milk supply vans, or miking through the police booths or the police beats. And the messages through electronic media, we have already talked about, they can be sent as usual WhatsApp messages, even the caller tune. Everyone is aware that these days the caller tune is related to the IEC or increasing awareness on corona. And when you are there in the community, it's always important that you keep your pocket handy, which will be provided to you so that you can refer to it if you want to see what messages to be delivered. Next slide, please. So when you are there in the community, Dr. Vivek has just now mentioned that there should be while communication, it's important that there is no stigma and discrimination. Everyone should be treated politely, and you should not be rude while giving your messages. It should be in a very subtle language, and so that people pay heed to what you are saying rather than, you know, giving it in a preaching mode. And when you are there in the community, it is important that while you are meeting people, you interact with them in open spaces and avoid direct physical contact with them, or avoid touching the surfaces which are there, and also maintain a distance of 1 meter. I forgot to mention one thing, that while you are going to the community, you need to carry some few important things with you. It is the mask, gloves, your formats, which you are going, like, which you will be using for your community surveillance, then the IEC material, the pamphlets, flyers, and your pocketbook. And always when you are interacting with others, then try to maintain a distance of 1 meter. And while you are asking questions, be very clear and listen to the people. If they have some questions, answer their queries and then note down the answers legibly. And when you leave that particular place, if you have given some message, take a feedback that whether the people have understood or not what you have tried to tell them, like regarding hand washing, like what are like how, for how much time should they wash their hands, and what are the areas they need to, like, you know, what is the procedure of hand washing. So all that you should keep in mind. Next slide, please. Then regarding the mask management, Dr. Ritu has emphasized about the use of mask in her session. And I believe by this time you would be aware that who all need to use a mask. And it is important to understand that using a mask will not give you 100% protection. It is for you to understand also while you are in the community. You should inform others also that other precautions, social distancing, hand hygiene, respiratory etiquette, all this is important. And hand hygiene along with mask management and maintaining a physical distance of more than 1 meter is effective to protect you from coronavirus infection, instead of only, you know, thinking about using a mask and thinking that it will give you 100% protection. So who should use a mask is that people who develop fever, cough, or difficulty in breathing, a person who's taking care of a sick person, if you are a health worker in a healthcare facility, and the field healthcare staff while going in for community surveillance or contact tracing or for IEC. So how the mask has to be used is very important. So the mask, like you will be stressing that using a mask, who has to use a mask, how it has to be used, and how it has to be disposed of. So first talk about how to use a mask correctly. So the mask which we are talking about here is the medical or the surgical mask, which has three pleats, or it is three layered also. So unfold the pleats, then the mask, the piece should face downwards, and place the mask on the nose. There is a nose piece and it should be pressed upon the nose so that it gets tightened over it. And then after fitting the nose piece over the nose bridge, tie the strings. Upper string is tied above the head behind, above the ears, and the lower string at the back of the neck. And then see that there is no gap, and the mask fits tightly on the nose, mouth, and chin, leaving no gaps on either side. Do not pull the mask down or hang it from the neck, and avoid touching the mask while in use. It has been seen that people are in habit of touching their face at least, you know, 20 times in an hour. So while you're in the community and during the current situation of COVID-19, it has already been stressed that we should avoid touching our mouth, face, and eyes, nose with unwashed hands. And while you're using mask also, the same thing applies. And the mask, they are the replaceable single-used mask, so they should be replaced with a dry mask as soon as they become damp or humid, or after 6 to 8 hours. So what this is about, how to use a mask, and now how to remove and dispose the mask. So the single-use mask, they should never be reused, and do not touch the outer surface of the mask while removing also. To remove the mask, first untie the string below and then the string above, and holding the string, the upper string, you should dispose of the mask in a closed bin. And after removing the mask, you should again perform hand hygiene. And to disinfect the mask can be put either in a bleach solution for 30 minutes and then it can be disposed of as a regular waste. Next slide, please. So now we'll talk about the precaution and safety measures while you are there in the field, while moving around in the community. We have already talked, but just reinforcing it again, that use a three-layered mask to cover your face. Make sure it is properly worn. Maintain a distance of at least 1 meter. Avoid touching your face, eyes, nose, mouth at all times. Wash your hands with soap and water frequently, or use alcohol-based hand rub. Perform hand hygiene before using a mask and after discarding the mask. And avoid touching or direct physical contact with anything or anybody while you are moving in the community. And once you reach back home, dispose of the mask if you have not done. And then it should be soaked in bleach solution. I've already talked about it, or dispose of it in a closed dustbin. Wash your hands with soap and water or alcohol-based hand rub. Wipe down whatever you have carried with you, like the purse or the mobile or the tablet, which you would have been using for entering the data online. So all these things can be wiped with the disinfectant, or you can use a hand sanitizer. If you get any symptoms, you have to monitor yourself for symptoms, because while you are in community, you are not aware if you would have come across somebody who's from a case, or somebody who's infected or in the incubatory period. So it's better that you monitor yourself for symptoms like fever, cough, difficulty breathing. And if you have such symptoms, you should self-isolate yourself and call immediately the helpline number of the Ministry of Health, Government of India, or the local helpline number and follow the instructions accordingly. Next slide, please. So next slide is on the myths and facts. I think already somebody has asked a question also about with summers coming up, the coronavirus will be killed. So the fact is that COVID-19 has been detected in all areas, including areas with hot and humid weather. The best way to protect yourself against COVID-19 is by frequently washing your hands with soap and water, covering your cough, practicing hand hygiene and practicing respiratory etiquette, and avoid going to crowded places and maintain a physical distance of 1 meter while interacting with others. And Dr. Tanzin has already mentioned in the initial session that the virus survivability decreases as the temperature increases or it goes above more than 25 degrees, and at around 50 degrees centigrade, the virus is killed. Then the next is spraying alcohol or disinfectant over the body can prevent infection. That is not the case because the infection is from the mucous membrane when the virus enters your body. And regularly rinsing the nose with saline will prevent the infection. So the fact is that rinsing the nose with saline has in few cases helped in containing the common cold, but has no evidence to suggest that it is effective against novel coronavirus. And Ministry of Ayush has also come up with some methods to boost the immunity in the current situation, but there is a disclaimer that this will not give you 100% protection against the COVID virus infection. Next slide, please. Coronavirus can pass through chicken meat. Poultry products. However, it is always advised to have properly cleaned chicken, as we know that the virus gets killed above 50 degrees centigrade. And there is no evidence that chicken and meat can pass on the infection to 80% of the people have recovered from the disease without needing special treatment, but information on the virus, the statement is, or the myth is, the person with coronavirus can recover fully and be no more infectious. This is the point. 80% of the people have recovered without needing treatment. And as has been observed from the current evidence, that 80% of the people have mild symptoms, and usually people with mild symptoms, they recover within 14 days. And if the disease is severe, it may take up to 3 weeks to 8 weeks for the people to recover, or some may, you know, succumb to the infection. But it as a precautionary measure, even after 14 days when the person has been discharged, they should try to self-isolate themselves at homes and avoid going to crowded places and follow other general precautions like hand hygiene as a precautionary measure, as there is no evidence as of now. Another statement is that eating raw garlic, sesame seeds will protect you against the virus. Fact is that garlic is a healthy food and that has other benefits, but does not protect against the coronavirus infection. The virus can die easily once it is out of the body. We do not know about this particular virus as of now, and similar viruses survive from 8 to 24 hours depending on the types of surfaces. There have been evidence and a review of literature has suggested that it persists for few hours to few days on surfaces, porous and non-porous, and it may vary. And the virus survivability depends upon the temperature, humidity of a place. And another mode of transmission is through respiratory droplets when an infected person sneezes or coughs. I think this is all.
Yes, Dr. Meera. There were a few questions which were asked in the question box, and one of the major questions that people have is